Hello everyone, I'm Mary Jane Newman and I'm the artistic director of the Sanctuary Series, a piano series here in the hamlet of South Salem at the South Salem Presbyterian Church. So this afternoon we have the privilege of presenting Jeffrey Beigel, an American pianist of great fame and notoriety, especially for his extraordinary and unusual performances of early music. You will be hearing today the music of Bach and Mozart, Chopin, Rachmaninoff, and Gershwin. So we hope you enjoy the concert here on Channel 20. We thank Channel 20 for their support of the series. We thank Henry Wolf for his commitment to the arts in our town and for being a part of our adventure here in the Sanctuary Series. So please come and join us both at the church, and we welcome you anytime. Thank you so much, and we hope you enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, I am very honored that you are here and that you all started this series and kind of invited us to come and play. You know, we're also through the Sanctuary Series page on Facebook Live, which is kind of an innovation, being able to get the performances out to the world. And it's actually 20 years ago, it was 1997, that I came up with this crazy idea when computers started to become the norm, and I didn't even have one yet. I said, you know, remember 1950s when an apartment house had X number of families and maybe two people had a black and white television set? That was a big deal. Everybody came to watch the TV. I thought, how about with a computer? Why can't we expand classical music to new audiences and bring it outside of just the performing venue and bring it to audiences through their computers? And here we are 20 years later doing exactly what I wanted to do 20 years ago. And we did do it 20 years ago, but it wasn't as prominent as it is now and as easily accessible. So, you know, grateful to Sanctuary Series for bringing me here again and also for letting the performances go out to the world through their Facebook page on Facebook Live, which I think is a fabulous innovation for so many things. So this happens, of course, Chopin, definitely written for the more modern piano, although I have played a piano in Milan at one of the villas there, and they had many different instruments of the age where they came from. A Mozart piano with a drum in it, with a pedal. If you played the pedal, the drum would play on the other end. Chopin's, a piano that was made second to Chopin's. I played some of his music on there, and the proprietor of the villa said, don't force. You don't have to, just play very easy and it'll give you what you want. A totally different technique to play on the pianos that Chopin's time had in their possession. And then, of course, going on to Rachmaninoff, who very much loved Chopin and loved Mozart and loved Mendelssohn. And they wrote for piano. And then on top of that, Gershwin, who loved piano and loved Debussy and loved Ravel. And the prelude that is on the program after Rachmaninoff G major prelude is Gershwin's G major prelude called Rubato, which is a nickname. It was in 1923 when he wrote this prelude, Vanity Fair magazine called it a tribute to Chopin, and you'll hear why. And then finally, for the last selection, is the Rhapsody in Blue, which is the 1924 score, taking the piano and orchestra parts and putting them together by Dr. Alicia Zizzo. And I remember it was also 20 years ago that she brought it to me, to my home, and said, please proofread it. I can't see it anymore, it's just a blur. And I asked her where all these missing measures came from, some 88 measures. And she said, well, they were all in the original manuscript. The ending is a little different, some notes are different. Where we thought he's meant to slow down, he meant to slow up. He likes Pocahontas. And there's a lot of things in there that when you hear them, you say, I haven't heard that before. They're not mine, they're all George. So it's a different kind of a style that I bring to it. I listen to a lot of George Gershwin's playing on piano rolls and kind of taking history into account that the 1920s were the roaring 20s. You had the dances of the time, the Charlestons, and you had vaudeville, and you had also ragtime, which was more of a straightforward rhythmic style, whereas swing that came 10, 15, 20 years later was kind of playing around with the rhythm. So I personally don't do that in my Gershwin playing. I bend it slightly, but I don't swing it. Gershwin didn't either. And a lot of the other components of the Rhapsody in Blue, which is a kind of a melting pot of styles, you will hear Jewish dances in there, like the Freilach. I don't know how many people know the Freilach. So you'll hear all these components of the times, of Gershwin's time, and also the heritage that he brought, that his parents brought with them from Eastern Europe. So it's that kind of a piece. It's a tip of the hat to his heritage. So without further ado, Chopin, Rachmaninoff, and Gershwin. Thank you.
Thank you.
We want to thank Channel 20 for their graciousness in presenting our concert series, Sanctuary Series, here in the hamlet of South Salem. And we're very, very happy today to have the brilliant pianist, American artist, Jeffrey Beigel with us. He thrilled our audience. I think we had two or three encores, could have gone on and on, but I opened the door to give him a break after his brilliant performance. And I heard from many of the people out in the reception how extraordinary the concert was. So thank you so much, Jeffrey. How did you feel about playing here today? Tell us a little bit about your experience.
You know, it felt like magic. I was kind of in a trance because it was such an intimate audience. And the piano was beautiful, and the music just really came to life here. It just felt very comforting. I didn't feel as though I were pressured or nervous. It just felt like I was with a group of friends sharing beautiful music.
Well, you did that, and we hope to have you back again in another 2 years. Jeffrey was an artist 2 years ago. The audience was so thrilled by him that we invited him back. He's the first return performer to Sanctuary Series. And from what I heard in the reception, our audience very much wants to have you as a regular part of the series. So we thank you very much. Those of you who watched the entire concert or will watch the concert will note that I am the magician's assistant on the first half. And I realized how much I hate turning pages, but I was completely entranced by your Mozart.
Oh, thank you. And you did a great job of turning pages, too.
Thank you.
Turning back pages and forward pages.
Thank you. It was actually great fun. So we're so happy to have had you. We hope that those who watch the concert on Channel 20 will be as engaged and entranced by your playing as was our audience here in the church. So we hope that those of you who listen to the concert today will come and be a part of the series and join us here 4 o'clock on many Sunday afternoons. The next concert is with Dee Wu, another fantastic talent.
Fabulous.
And we hope that you will continue to support the series. We thank again Channel 20 and Henry Wolf for their commitment to us. And play on, Jeff.
Play on. Have a terrific rest of the season and for many, many years, and we'll all grow old together.
Good. Beautiful. Thanks so much.
You're watching Lewisboro Community Television, Channel 20.